Welcome to episode one of PaigeY Interviews Cambridge Graduates. Today we're going to be chatting about some of the courses you can study at Cambridge, as well as the fields that my friends decided to specialise in. I'm also going to be asking them for some fun facts that they learnt during their degrees. Feel free to comment below what you think sounds like the coolest course, and vote for who has the best fun fact as well. My friends get super competitive, so they will love that. Could you briefly summarise your course, and how did you decide what subject area to specialise in?
Course is physics. It's physics. Doing maths and stuff to understand how the world works and that. I chose it because I like doing maths, but it all gets like a bit abstract, so I thought, hey, maybe physics is for me. Three times in total, I nearly switched over to computer science.
So the English literature course, the first 2 years, you do six modules. Five of them are time periods, so you start chronologically, you go from medieval all the way up to modern, and you do something called practical criticism, and that's just like the same as maybe an unseen task at A-level or GCSE, where you get given a text and you're like, write about a thing, about this text. You do a dissertation in those first 2 years on one of those papers, and then in third year you have to still do practical criticism. It just gets a little bit harder. You do tragedy, from Greek tragedy all the way up to like you can write about pop songs, which is cool, and then you can choose a dissertation. You can do whatever you want, and you choose two more papers. You can either do a second dissertation or two subject papers. I did a second dissertation and the material Renaissance paper, and I chose that because in my first 2 years that was my favourite module.
I do chemistry. I do natural sciences, then specialised in chemistry in third year, and this year I've been doing a project in theoretical chemistry, so that's like the border between chemistry and physics, like quantum mechanics and stuff like that.
All very interesting stuff, isn't it, Paige?
Yeah.
As the others have probably told you, the NATSE course starts very broad, and then as you go on through the years you specialise. At the start I was doing chemistry, physics, materials and maths, and then as I went on I realised that chemistry and maths were my favourites, so I took those in second year, which is kind of a weird combination. Usually people do physics and maths, or like chemistry and materials or something, but I really liked the, you know, more physics-y side, more quantum mechanical side of chemistry, and so I ended up specialising in those in third and fourth year, and then now I'm really happy like doing a coding project in chemistry and doing the whole quantum mechanics side of it. I find that the most interesting part. So you can kind of like tailor your final option throughout all your courses throughout the year, so it's kind of an interesting course in that sense. Sorry, bird was just flying around distracting us. Paige, I thought you had that under control.
They're just the extras in the video.
Yeah.
Ooh, so my course was a three-year course. The first 2 years were built up of sort of general English from medieval to present day. In the third year, I specialised in poetry and I dabbled a bit in medieval literature.
Mm-hmm. Okay, material science isn't really well known, especially to like sixth form students, I guess. So they teach them classic biology, chemistry, physics, but material science lies at this intersection mainly between chemistry and physics. We're looking at materials, why they have the properties they do based on the atomic structure. I initially wanted to do physics at universities. I applied to do physics everywhere, but I decided that it was not as fun as I first thought, and I wanted something a bit more tactile, maybe is the word, something more physical. So I decided to do material science. I just know, like, oh, look at steel, ooh, bendy, ooh, wood got grains, ooh.
It's like a pyramid start, doing four different subjects in the first year, and you specialise eventually, which I specialised into chemistry, and specifically organic chemistry, because I found physics to be quite hard. So chemistry, much more enjoyable.
Initially, I didn't really know what I wanted to specialise in, other than I wanted to do science. So in first year, I was as broad as possible, and I took biology of cells and chemistry and physics. And I kind of liked all of them in first year, but I decided I liked chemistry and physics quite a bit more than biology. So I ditched biology after first year. Then after second year, I decided I wanted to specialise in chemistry because I just kind of preferred chemistry a bit more over physics. So that's where I ended up specialising in. I ended up doing a chemistry degree.
Can you share a fun fact you learnt during your degree?
Yes. A lot of inventions we think are man-made actually already existed in nature. And I can give a couple of examples of these, some of which will shock and surprise you. For example, cogs, teeth on cogs, they exist in
plant hoppers
made out of a certain protein, I can't remember the name of now. Chitin? I don't know, it's not my... it doesn't matter. Yeah. And even a fission nuclear reactor has been found to exist in nature, underground somewhere. You can Google it to look at the specifics of how it works. So really, humanity is just copying what already exists.
It's one that I found interesting was with the relativity. There's stuff like how the, well, in everyday speech, it's obvious that if I think two things are simultaneous, then you should as well. If things happen at the same point in time for me, of course they do for you as well. But then, as you know, Einstein realised that actually just because to me two things are simultaneous, to someone else they might not be. And not out of some sort of like subjectiveness to it. They objectively and clearly just happen at different points of time for different people.
Mm-hmm. Mind blown, guys.
The reason that things are called uppercase and lowercase, like the fonts, is because there were literally, when you were typesetting, there were literally two cases and the capital letters were in the uppercase. And the lowercase letters were in the lowercase, like physical cases. So that's why they're called the uppercase and the lowercase.
That's the funnest fact I've heard so far.
Fun fact. It's not really a fact. We learned a lot about the original syntheses of natural products and drugs back in like the 50s and 60s. So it's not a fact so much as like a massive like process that you just like know how to do.
Wasn't that fun then?
No, literally, like from fourth year, like there's not really fun facts. It's just like a bunch of mechanisms that you learn.
Boring.
It genuinely.
Oh, my best fun fact. Well, it's not fun and it's not a fact.
My fun fact is that a lot of common phrases that we use today actually come from Shakespeare. So things like jealousy is a green-eyed monster, or that glitters is not gold, wild goose chase, all's well that ends well, all those sort of common phrases or idioms you've heard of, a lot of them actually come from Shakespeare, so go and look it up after this video.
He needs more credit.
Yeah. He was a great guy. He had a lot to contribute to the English language.
Not so much an individual fun fact, but like just like the idea of being able to just use pure maths and pure like computing to start with like an equation which determines the behavior of an electron, and you can build that up and determine like the whole properties of molecules and things. So start by just knowing about the mass of an electron, and you can build it up to determine like the boiling points of water and stuff by like combining together all these quantum mechanical principles and eventually building up. I mean, it takes a lot of computing power, and it's pretty much impossible to do a lot of those things, but it's kind of interesting that in theory you can do all that.
I'm not sure it's fun, but what I did learn, especially in first year, is just how much of what you learn in A-level is an oversimplification, or in some cases wrong. Realise that what I'd learnt in the past was not really the whole truth.
Yeah. And if you've watched till the end, I thought I would do some quick answers to the questions myself. As many of you will know, I studied natural sciences. It's great for postponing decisions. I feel at 18 it's really hard to know what you want to do with your life, but it lets you carry on with multiple subjects for just that little bit longer and try stuff out first before committing. I specialised in astrophysics just because I thought space was cool, and that's about as deep as it goes. And fun fact time, when massive stars explode, they can outshine a whole galaxy. That rounds up the first episode. Watch out for the next episode coming next week. Comment below any further questions you have. Give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, share it with all your friends if you find it useful, and we'll see you next time. Bye.